Good evening. So very warm welcome to all the participants for this session. First and of course, a very special welcome to our chief guest, Mr. Arun Goyal, Secretary of Ministry of Heavy Industries. Thank you very much for participating in coming to this session. So immediately after announcement of the PLI scheme, may also warmly welcome Mr. Amit Mehta, Joint Secretary of Ministry of Heavy Industry. A special welcome to all members of both SIAM and APA and colleagues from ARAI, ICAT, and other institutions, and also officials of the Ministry of Industries. We will now start the formal agenda of the session with welcome remarks by Mr. Kenichi Aikawa, President SIAM, who is joining us virtually. He's from Japan, from the video link. So may I now request Mr. Kenichi Aikawa, President SIAM, to give his welcome remarks.
Thank you, Mr. Melon. Your Excellency, Mr. Arun Goyal, Secretary Ministry of the Heavy Industries, Mr. Sanjay Kapoor, President ACMA, distinguished guests from the Indian auto industry, ladies and gentlemen, Namaskar. SIAM and ACMA are happy to host and welcome you to this special interactive session on the production linked incentive scheme for Indian auto industry. It feels good to see a physical event after a long, long time. I would have also liked to join and meet His Excellency and other members personally, but I'm sorry I'm in Japan right now. Kindly excuse me for participating virtually. Let me first thank the government, Honorable Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, Honorable Minister of Heavy Industry, Dr. Mahendra Nath Pandey, Secretary, Ministry of Heavy Industry, Mr. Arun Goyal, and all other senior members of the government involved in working out the PLI scheme for Indian auto industry. Please accept our sincere gratitude for launching this PLI scheme. Ladies and gentlemen, we understand the government's objective of reducing carbon emissions, reducing oil imports, and promoting Make in India. The PLI scheme is a step in this direction. The scheme shows government commitment to support Indian auto industry by incentivizing battery electric and hydrogen vehicles and a selected list of components and technologies for auto parts manufacturing. It reinforces government's focus on encouraging local investment and manufacturing, thereby building an Atma Nirbhar Bharat. Over the next 5 years, this PLI scheme is expected to attract fresh investment in new technologies and generate more business opportunities in the industry. Today, we have invited His Excellency, Mr. Arun Goyal, to understand the original thought processes with which this PLI scheme has been designed. Sir, we have received an outline of the scheme and are waiting for full details of the scheme. You would be aware, SIAM's position has been to encourage all technologies which will help in carbon emission reduction and oil import reduction. If the PLI scheme can cover all such technologies like ethanol flex fuel system, CNG system, LNG system, and strong hybrid electric system, it would help in multiplying our effort to achieve the same goal and promote local manufacturing. On the final detail, SIAM members will discuss among themselves, and if we have any submission, we will come to you. We are now keen to hear your valuable thought. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thank you, Aikawa-san. Thank you for your opening remarks. May I now invite Mr. Arun Goyal, our Chief Guest Secretary, Ministry of Heavy Industries, for a special address.
Mr. Kenichi Ayukawa and friends, thank you very much for hosting me and my team this evening. I think all of you know the details of the scheme, am I right? Because we had emailed you immediately after the press conference. Because I think we can design this discussion accordingly. Am I right?
It has been sent to all the participants.
So they've seen the soft copies. So do you want us to run through the scheme in detail, or would you like to put questions and we react to that? Doubts, any doubts to be cleared? Okay. So let me tell you, as Mr. Kenichi Ayukawa said, the basic thought behind the scheme is, now Indian auto industry is a grand success and we are proud of it. Over last 3.5 decades, we have achieved many things. But at the same time, you know, while we say we are number one in numbers, in value terms, we are at number 11. All of you know the reason, so I don't have to say all those things. Secondly, in the history, more than 100-year history of auto industry, the global auto industry, the biggest disruption is happening now. If we do not take the new path, in addition to the path which we have, we may miss the bus. Indian auto industry, which is the pride of India, cannot let that happen. And government also is very clear. We want Indian auto to be at the forefront globally in the changing scenario. Now here, two things are happening, as you know. One is the internal combustion engine by itself. But that's not going to disappear. You know, we know. But within ICE, the way what we are calling advanced automotive technologies, which is broadly the things, the way the shared vehicles, connected vehicles, autonomous vehicles are coming, the kind of imports which we are doing, auto electricals, auto electronics, and the transmission and engine. So where the supply chains in our country are either non-existent or weak, we want that, because there's a structural change required. It can't happen overnight. But this PLI scheme is going to act as a catalyst to help the industry to bring about that structural change. So that is the basic philosophy behind it. With that, we have tried to keep it very simple, although it's looking very complicated when you look at the charts, but then your industry itself is so complex. So through the complexities, we are making the things simple. So I'll broadly say, the criteria which we have prescribed, most of you are going to fulfill. So OEMs and tier ones. Because after all, we are looking at the champions here. And tier two and three would automatically get the benefit through OEMs and tier ones. So you know your supply chains. Investment. So what we are asking for the OEMs of four-wheelers, 2,000 crores over 5 years. For two-wheelers and three-wheelers, 1,000 crores. For components, 250 crores. And if it's a new non-automotive investor, it's 500 for components, and for OEMs, it is 2,000. So it's not a big game. All of you know you can do it. So then comes, because there's a time lag. We are conscious of it. The kind of approvals which are required in auto industry, it takes about 18 months and so forth. The biggest plus point here is, what is the payout? Let's be frank about it. You are expecting 4 to 6%. So when all of you are saying it has been cut down, what has been cut down? It has been tripled. Now the payout is up to 18%. Now, you said companies are not investing in India because of the cost disabilities. With this scheme, I request you to please compare the cost disabilities post this scheme with any other country. What you projected in the stakeholder consultation, We are fully meeting. It's not like the usual government way, you ask 10 and we give 5. So the payout is up to 18%. It fully meets the cost disability. And this whole scheme, I think there was something that is going to give power to Babu. No, absolutely not. Let's look at FAME. None of you, I have been in chair for 1 year and 9 months, has ever come to me with a complaint that FAME is giving you approval problems. None of you, neither association nor individually. We are going to administer this scheme absolutely the same way. From the organizations like ICAT or ARI, which are run by you. They will be data-driven, pre-approval, so that you don't come back to us again. We'll make it absolutely simple, not for the sake of saying, you tell me what you want, we shall do it. So I think this is the broad background. If you want to see the charts, we can show you. We have the presentation. I don't know, you want it? Okay. So our Joint Secretary, Mr. Amit Mehta, will run through the charts.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. So we'll start with a brief presentation that we have made for the benefit of the industry leaders gathered here. Can we go to the next slide? So these are the basic scheme details. So our scheme, PLI scheme, will be open for both the existing automotive companies as well as the new non-automotive investors. Here we have defined the new non-automotive investors as those companies which do not have any revenue from the manufacturing of automobile or auto components business as on 31st 3 2021. Now the base year has been taken as the financial year 1920, and this scheme will be implemented for a period of 5 years, and it will start from the financial year 22-23. Now we'll go to the basic eligibility criteria for both the existing automotive companies as well as the new non-automotive investors. Can we go to the next slide? So for the existing automotive companies, the global group revenue and the investment have been taken as the two criteria. For the investment for the auto OEM, it is 3,000 crore, and the global group revenue has been pegged as 10,000 crore. Similarly, for the auto component, it is the global investment is 150 crore, and the global group revenue is 500 crore. Now, for the new non-automotive investor, we have kept the global net worth as 1,000 crore. So all these values are as on financial year ending 31st March 2021. Besides these basic eligibility criteria, we will be having the investment criteria. As Secretary Sir had mentioned, so we'll show that in the next slide. So now the companies will have to make a minimum new cumulative domestic investment after 1st April 2021, which is defined here in this chart, and we have divided this into 5 categories. The first is the champion OEM scheme, which is except the two-wheelers and three-wheelers, where over a period of 5 years, an investment of 2,000 crore has to be made. Similarly, for the champion OEM scheme, for two-wheelers and three-wheelers, it has been kept as 1,000 crores. For the new non-automotive investor who will like to come in the OEM scheme, the investment over a period of 5 years has been 2,000 crores. For the components, it has been kept as 250 crores. And for the new non-automotive investor, over a period of 5 years, an investment of 500 crores needs to be made. And this investment will be made starting 1st April 2021. So if a company wants to invest before the time period which is prescribed in the scheme, they are most welcome to do that. But in case a company fails to meet the cumulative investment criteria in a particular year, then for that year he will not be getting the incentive, But in case he meets the criteria in the following year, he will get the incentive. Next. Now, as we all know, we have two components of the scheme. One is for the vehicle manufacturers, and the other is for the auto component companies. The eligibility has been defined as the vehicles have to be pre-approved, and the components will also have to be pre-approved by the Ministry of Heavy Industries. So depending upon the technical developments, this list can be modified and changed from time to time. And here also the minimum value addition has been kept at 50%, and as in the FAME scheme, the phased manufacturing program has to be followed. Next. Now the applicants will have to apply for registration of their products as eligible products to seek incentive in this scheme. This eligibility will be done by the testing agencies of MHI, and it will be in a most transparent manner, and we will be having robust monitoring system for that. Then the testing agency will also certify the domestic value addition in the eligible product in line with the phased manufacturing program of the FAME II. Also, one thing is very important here, a product can get incentive either at the vehicle level or at the component level. It cannot claim incentive at both the categories. If that is done, we have strict penalties for that. The company might just get disqualified. Next. Now the incentives are based on the determined sale value. The determined sale value will be defined as the incremental eligible sale of a particular year over the base year. So incentives will be calculated as a percentage of the slabs that we will be showing in the next slide. Next. Yeah, we'll come to that later on. So while we were making the scheme, it was thought that maybe in the base year, some of the existing automobile companies will not be having any sales from the advanced automotive components. So we decided for the first year, the minimum determined sales for the champion OEM scheme will be kept at 125 crores, and similarly for the component champion scheme, it would be kept at 25 crores. But then here, there's a condition that year-on-year basis, a 10% growth is required. Even for the new non-automotive investors, they would not be having any eligible sales in the base year. So the new non-automotive investors would also have to meet the criteria as defined here in year one, that is financial year 22-23. Next. The incentives are based on the various slabs that we have made, and for the champion OEM scheme, it would be varying from 13% to 16%. And if a company achieves a cumulative determined sales of over 10,000 crores in the fifth year, so the incremental sales over 10,000 crore will get an additional incentive of 2%. Similarly, for the component champion scheme, if a company achieves a sales of 1250 crores, cumulative sales of 1250 crores over a period of 5 years, then it will get an additional incentive of 2%. Besides that, for the components which go into battery electric vehicles and hydrogen fuel cell vehicles, an additional 5% incentive will be given. Next. So these are the incentive payout for the different years, and the total incentive over a period of 5 years will be around 25,938 crores. Next. So some of the expected outcomes are the total investment that we expect from this scheme is rupees 42,500 crores over a period of 5 years. Similarly, the incremental production which we expect to achieve over a period of 5 years will be 2,31,500 crores, and the total additional jobs created would be 7.5 lakhs, and incremental tax collection, direct and indirect, over the scheme period is expected to be 10,851 crores. Yeah, that's all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Goyal and Mr. Mehta. I think congratulations are due to all of us in the industry and to you all. And of course, this wouldn't have been possible with the kind of midnight oil that you guys have burnt on our behalf. So maybe we should acknowledge this with a round of applause. And sir, thank you so much for sharing with us the basic philosophy, indeed very profound, that we need to create supply chains that are non-existent or weak. And indeed, we do believe that this scheme will be a catalyst for bringing about a structural change in the entire automotive value chain. And Mr. Mehta, thank you very much for that very lucid presentation. And on a lighter note, sir, please use green colors. You're talking about a green industry, and you're talking about an 18% payout. So red, we definitely won't be in red.
No, that is because then most of you say we are biased towards EV. That's why we don't want to give that impression.
Sir, then if you acknowledge we are in red, we are hungry for more. jokes apart, sir, profound thanks to all of you. And before I open the floor open for questions or any interjection or a comment that you may have, I would invite Mr. Vinod Agarwalji. Of course, you all know him. He's the MD and CEO at Volvo Eicher Commercial Vehicles and also the treasurer of SIAM. Sir, please, for your comment or a question that you may have. Please take the mic to... Yeah, thank you.
First of all, my compliments to the Government of India and to the Ministry of Heavy Industries for coming out with this scheme, which is very, very bold, and also very good for the industry and for helping the industry to migrate towards the newer technologies, which are absolutely, as you mentioned, if we don't take these steps now, of course, then we will be left behind. So if we have to move forward, we have to become the leaders in the auto industry, then of course this is the step in the right direction. But there are one or two clarifications which I wanted to take from you. Like, for example, the scheme says that the group turnover criteria, it is 10,000 crores, and the companies in the group, each company has to meet the criteria of either 26% voting power or appointment of more than 50% of the directors. Now, in this situation where there is a holding company and a subsidiary company, while the holding company will meet this criteria, the subsidiary company will not meet this criteria, because holding company will have these rights, while the subsidiary company will not have these rights. Now, if the subsidiary company wants to make these investments, or they want to pursue the investments in the new technologies, then will they also be eligible as per the group turnover? Even though both holding and subsidiary are part of the same group, but there is one mention in the conditions that each company has to meet this criteria.
I think, Vinodji, you have asked a very specific question. I cannot answer like that. We want investment. You know, that's the first thing. The objective of the scheme is, as I have said. So I can only assure you, the point which you have said, we shall look into it, how we can make it possible.
Like, for example, specifically for us, like we are a...
No, I have understood. So I would suggest Rajneesh is here. He's not there, Rajneesh. So have you understood the point? So can you answer? Is it eligible?
No, I can. I can give you the example. Like,
no, no. It's okay.
Yeah, it will be, because we are talking about global investment and the global group revenue.
No, he's talking of the other thing. He's talking of the fine print. Jo humne likha hua niche.
They will be eligible because.
No, he is going into the fine print beneath it.
In the print, you have written that each company has to meet this criteria.
So he's so
saying the individual subsidiary has to meet the criteria.
Because, for example, we are a subsidiary of Eicher Motors, our Volvo Eicher.
And you have Roja, I think we would request you to give us a full detail.
Okay.
There may be other such things. That's the objective of this consultation. So you please give it by tomorrow morning.
Okay.
So we'll see how we can do it. Because objective is investment. Objective is to include, not exclude.
Absolutely.
So you please understand that.
I think we have
now if some word somewhere is doing that problem, we have to find an answer.
Okay.
So maybe there's no problem. Maybe there's a problem. So that's why I'm saying we have to. You have to give us specifically. Have you gone to the fine print?
No, I was reading the the release which has been made. So I read it that.
Which page you are looking? Let's see. Let's see which point you are saying.
It says that a company must satisfy both the criteria.
I saying, Look right. Yeah. 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 Which point you are saying?
On this first page.
I'm on that page.
A company must satisfy both the criteria to be eligible as automotive champions. So you are saying at the company level. If you say at the group level, then of course it is fine. But if you are saying the company must meet both the criteria, then of course the subsidiary companies will get excluded.
So it should be group?
Yes.
Okay. So yeah, because this wording came from finance, so you have to sit with him and see. Ye aapne dala tha ki finance mein? He is saying this point.
Sir, niche wala jo.
नहीं आप ऊपर ग्रुप कंपनी तो लिखा हुआ है आप क्यों उसको आप देखिए ना ऊपर जो स्टार के बाद लिखा हुआ है दैट वर्ड ऑफ ग्रुप कंपनी
टर्नओवर ग्रुप कंपनीज ऑफ कोर्स 10000 करोड़
सो दैट्स राइट ग्रुप कंपनी
बट इफ यू से
नो व्हाई आर यू गोइंग नेगेटिव
नो आई एम जस्ट आस्किंग
बी पॉजिटिव नॉर्मली यू से वी आर नेगेटिव
नो आई एम नॉट नेगेटिव
आप स्टार के बाद पढ़िए ना विनोद जी नहीं जस्ट टेबल के नीचे क्या लिखा है ग्रुप कंपनी
या
राइट
यस
तो नीचे उसी की कंटिन्यूएशन है
या नो सो लॉन्ग एज
We'll take care of it.
Yeah. Right, sir.
And this another
please.
Another question could be that if suppose in a company which is in both automotive as well as components, both may be the separate businesses, and if they want to make investments in both these divisions,
yeah, you're welcome.
So then they will be eligible for both.
Yeah, yeah. We had long discussion on this. We are very clear. Okay. See. During the stakeholders thing, various drafts were changed. So the current final draft does not bar. It only says for one product you cannot get incentive twice. So for the second point which you raised, the answer is definitive yes.
Thank you, sir.
For the question number one which you raised, there is a point which we have to take care. And I think we'll be able to take care.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Again,
thank
compliments
you.
For yeah.
the
very
good. Thank you, Mr. Agarwal. I now invite Mrs. Shraddha Suri Marwa, Vice President ACMA, as also Chairperson of Subros.
जो नीचे Roman 2 है, Roman 2, where is a company? Table के नीचे है group company, right? Star के बाद. If that wording is here, it's okay.
Yeah, then we should say either.
No. आप ये बताइए ना वो यहाँ पे आता है तो problem solve होती है.
Yeah.
Because you see, we can't see all those things. You can see. बिल्कुल. ये ऐसे होता है. This is the stakeholder. Yeah.
Yeah, Shraddha, please.
Thank you. Grateful to the Honorable Prime Minister and the Ministry for launching the scheme. It definitely envisions the path to Atmanirbharta. So I just had two questions. One was whether JVs would be eligible applicants for the scheme. And the second was whether joint ventures.
Yeah, of course. We are not barring anything.
All right. And the other one was that I couldn't read that in the drafts, so that's why. And the other one was whether import substitution would be considered. Because this may lead to localization, but it may not actually necessarily lead to increase in sales or lead to some incremental sales.
I think the first point, we are not barring the JVs.
Sure, sir.
So in the current atmosphere, JVs are practical. That has to happen because advanced automotive technology things you can't probably achieve. All of you cannot achieve without JVs.
That's right.
You need new tie-ups, right? So that's obviously allowed. Which is the second point you said?
I said that
incrementally. You see, that's only, that was the incremental sales on the advanced automotive technology. Let's suppose your sales in the base year is 100 crore. But the advanced automotive technology which we are defining, it could be say 10 crores, it could be zero.
All right.
So if it is zero, then the minimum criteria comes in, which slide we showed, 125 for OEMs and 25 for auto components.
All right.
If it is 10,
mm-hmm.
then we are asking for 10% growth, but that is less than 25, so you have to meet 25. Let's suppose 100 was there, then 10% of 100 is 110. Then 25 will not be the minimum for you. For you, it will be 110. I hope that's clear.
Yeah, it is. It is. But just the clarification on import substitution. So if I'm already...
We are not at all talking of import substitution. That's a concept.
All right.
What we are talking, the sales out of advanced automotive technology products, which we are notifying from time to time.
Sure.
Now, the ones which we have notified, we are likely to notify soon, that list has come from these two sides.
All right.
So this is your list.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Thank you, sir.
So we are nowhere using the word import substitution.
Sure, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Shraddha. Maybe if you could raise your hand and we could bring the mic to you. Rahul, do you want to say something? Yeah, mic here, please.
I think there's a person at the back. Yeah, please.
Okay, I mean, I just...
Thank you, everyone.
Rahul. So Rahul, just... Yeah, I mean, just introduce yourself and so for convenience.
So
okay, please go ahead.
Yeah. Thank you, everyone.
And yeah, sorry, I couldn't see you because of the light in my eyes.
No problem.
Sir, could you introduce yourself and the company?
I'm HP Gupta from Hero Motor Corp Limited, world largest two-wheeler manufacturing company. So my question is that in case we are foraying in the electric vehicle, maybe say next year, and then FY20 is the base year where my electric vehicle sales is zero. So I will be getting the incentive on the sales numbers, sales value of each every year because my, the base year is zero.
Absolutely, yes. Because the base year is zero, then your minimum is 125.
Yeah.
Because you're in case of OEM. And 125 has to grow at the rate of 10% at least year on year.
So first 125 will also be qualifying for the incentive.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely.
And one more small clarification, I will read. In one of the policy document, it is written the component champion incentive scheme is a sales value linked scheme applicable on advanced automotive technology. Components of vehicle, CKD, SKD, comma, vehicle aggregates to two-wheeler, comma, three-wheeler. So my understanding is that parts, if coming in the complete format of two-wheeler kit or three-wheeler kit, those parts will be eligible for the incentive. Is that correct?
Absolutely. So, see, the whole vehicle, hydrogen fuel cell, battery electric, or anything future we may say. So, in case of which is not this, obviously the AET part of it.
And then investment, say 1,000 crore, should be only in the EV, not as a company as a whole, whether it is in ICE or on EV. So since EV is eligible, so investment should also be necessarily on EV.
That's what we like to say here. See, that's why we have given you free play. We are not coming in the way.
Okay.
Right? So we are intentionally keeping silent. Okay. Because you take your business decision. The reason is the investment we are seeking is, it makes you eligible. Without this, you can't get anything. But what you get is determined by the sales of that particular category.
Okay.
Thank you. Obviously, you will not bring investment, which is not going to give you sales, isn't it?
Thank you.
So they are linked, but we are not asking.
Thank you so much for that clarification.
Yeah,
thank you so much.
I'll first have Rahul and then to you.
Thanks. Secretary, sir, our gratitude and our compliments for such a huge scheme. I think across all sectors, it's the highest outlay. So thanks for that. One small clarification. On local content, what is the criteria of local content, minimum local content? Because we, as you have mentioned, it's a long supply chain and parts could be imported by either ourselves or our tier one suppliers or tier two suppliers.
So we have been following some system in FAME. So that's helpful to industry, right? So I think you know what you're asking and I'm answering you. If I answer too much, you'll be in trouble. So what is happening in the FAME shall be continued for the benefit of industry.
But FAME has only a defined, it is only for a particular technology.
Yeah, in the same technology, mm-hmm. how to determine the local content? That's a question which you have put. So since you are not taking benefit of FAME probably, so you are not aware, so my suggestion is, you talk to the FAME counterparts of yours, that will satisfy your question. I know it, we are helping you and we'll continue to help.
Okay, thanks, thanks.
Thank you, yeah, please.
Good evening, this is Kapoor, Malin Kapoor from Piaggio. Like everybody else, compliments for this policy. One small clarification. You probably half answered it, but I am taking the liberty of probing a little more. I'm aware of the FAME scenario, but I'm probing a little more. For the two-wheeler and three-wheeler segments, you mentioned in the policy that the incentive would be applicable on overall value of the sales that is there. First year, second year, third year, so on and so forth. Now, particularly when you come to electric vehicles, one of the largest components is batteries. Now, in this case, what may be happening is that on one side, the battery manufacturer would be possibly claiming certain amount of incentives. I'm presuming that as far as the OE is concerned, he would still be allowed to claim the incentive based on the overall cost of the turnover of the vehicle. Am I right in my understanding?
We are giving a very big benefit to EVs. So this should change the landscape. You know how much you have invested. There's a lot of talk, but all of you know how much investment is taken. All of you know which way the world is going. You know we need to go there. This scheme will incentivize you to say yes, because the answer to your question is yes. Explicit yes.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Mr. Datta, you
and
have a question.
You have missed out the third part. We have made a categorical clause, even FAME will be applicable. So for EVs, you are going to get three benefits. PLI Auto, PLI ACC, and the FAME. I don't want to say the number, because you have too many opponents. But you know what that number comes to. Thereafter, there is no reason why EV manufacturing does not take a leapfrog in India. There is absolutely no reason. All of you see it, you will talk about it in the evening.
I appreciate that. Well, we are in IC and EV both, so this is definitely a benefit on one direction.
Right, right. Thank you, Mr. Datta. Please bring a mic to him.
Sir, my name Datta. I'm from Ola Electric. Thank you, sir. Thanks for covering the new entrants also. Like us, of course, there are one or two more new entrants into the industry are here. So this will definitely benefit India in making, you know, this new technology into a very viable and also export higher potential. Only one small clarity, sir, on the battery and, of course, the vehicle, both are the. So if the, there's a PLI for battery also and then the vehicle also. I saw in the explanation that you gave, you said that as a OEM, only one product is available, the battery is not eligible. Or is it so? Or
no. See, we have a very categorical clause which I answered there. Right? What you are reading is that within the PLI Auto, let's suppose for a sunroof, you have taken the incentive on the component side. Then you fit that in the electric vehicle.
Yes.
You can't do it. You can take advantage on one side, not both sides, of this scheme. When it is the other scheme, yes.
There's a separate company which is making...
I don't know. Okay. I have answered your question.
Okay.
Is there a doubt in anybody's mind about his question? Well, why do you have doubt? Because it's unbelievable.
Ah.
That's why I told the gentleman there.
Right.
It's unbelievable.
Yes, true. Thank you. Yeah, I'm getting
Thank you once again, sir, for the very, very...
Sir, yeah, again, hearty congratulations to whole DHI team. We know a lot of midnight oil has been burned behind that for several months. And we are very happy today it's got announced. I'm sure with this initiative, India will be on the global map in terms of the new technology. And because of this, we'll be having a newer heights we will achieve. So thanks again to all the DHI team. Sir, most of the, I would say the doubts has been cleared, it's come out very well. The only one small, this one was an investment, because broadly what we understood is a global revenue is a criteria. After that, there is a criteria for your fixed assets. Once I pass that, we are entering into the second threshold. One is a 50% localization. Second is 10% year-on-year growth. And the third criteria is the investment. So just wanted to know, most of the things are clarified. Investment means definition is like a plant and machinery or dyes or something,
we
or
are,
it's like...
No, we are silent about it intentionally again.
Okay.
The investment definition should be derived across all PLIs the same way.
Okay.
So we have chosen to remain silent.
Okay, understood, sir.
For your comfort.
Understood, sir. Understood. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, Shan. I mean, you don't get a chance like this to talk to the authors, so please. And then don't come back to us. We won't answer anything. Vikram, please go ahead.
First of all, Vikram Gulati here from Toyota Kirloskar Motor. First of all, congratulations and thank you for bringing out such an excellent scheme. It's perhaps the biggest stimulus that the sector has got. And we are sure that with this, you know, we'll move faster towards the desired direction. This is clear, but I just wanted to confirm, when you say sales, it would also mean exports. So if somebody doing exports...
It includes both. It includes both.
Thank you.
Am I missing out on anybody? I mean, sir, I'm not too sure there's any other question, any closing remark that you would like to make.
I think we expect all of you to take full advantage of the scheme. And you should make a day come when you feel the allocation is less than what you are producing. We are looking forward to that date.
Right, sir. Thank you so much. So with your permission, can I now invite President of ACMA to propose a vote of thanks? Sanjay, please.
Thank you, Vinnie. Mr. Arun Goyal, Secretary, Ministry of Heavy Industries. Mr. Amit Mehta, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Heavy Industries. Ayukawa-san, President CM and MD and CEO, Maruti Suzuki. Rajesh and Vinnie, my colleagues from the automotive fraternity, ladies and gentlemen. As we conclude this interactive session with the Secretary of Heavy Industry, it is my privilege and pleasure to make a few concluding remarks and propose a vote of thanks. At the outset, I, along with all my colleagues, thank Mr. Sri Arun Goyalji and his entire team of officials for today's announcement of the PLI scheme for the automotive and the auto component sector. Congratulations are due to all of us in the automotive industry, both ACMA and CM, as this indeed is a great milestone in the history and a defining moment in this very disruptive industry and a very disruptive time. In accordance with our national priorities of energy security, climate change, and environment, the PLI scheme envisions creation of an Atmanirbhar, globally competitive, and future-ready Indian automotive sector. Thrust on incentivizing new-age technologies will facilitate creation of state-of-the-art automotive value chain in the country and give much-needed impetus to manufacturing of cutting-edge automotive products in India. Further, with the global economies de-risking their supply chain, the PLI will aid India in developing into an attractive alternate source of high-end auto component manufacturing base. As this would not have been possible without our Secretary and his team championing our cause with all other concerned stakeholders to ensure that this PLI is a reality. Mr. Amit Mehta, the industry also thankfully acknowledges your support and contribution. Ayukawa-san, heartiest congratulations to you as well, as I'm confident the PLI will further motivate our OEMs to carry on with their agenda of localization and redoubled zest. Thank you once again for your continued support. Last but not the least, I would also like to thank CM and ACMA, secretariats for being an effective bridge between the government and industry. Once again, my congratulations to all the state. I wish the industry prosperity and a glorious future. Thank you.
Thank you, Sanjay. Thank you.
I'll just, after a word of thanks, sorry, I just want to add one thing. See, some of the questions here which have been raised, if you want, we can incorporate that as FAQs.
That'd be wonderful, sir.
So that this comes on record.
Yeah. Yes, sir, that'd be right. Nice.
So I think that will facilitate the point. Yeah. So like this triple thing, which you said, wherever, like this one, the question raised.
Yes.
So we'll you give us those questions.
We will, sir.
And frame the answers also. We'll edit the answers.
Right, only sure, thing. Sir, sure.
You know the answers.
Sir, and we will wait. We'll also pick up questions from Pune and Chennai, and then once we'll consolidate all of them, yeah.
I want it very quick.
Sure.
So it's better that you give yours today.
Okay.
We
edit. Right. Right.
You give Pune ones after Pune,
okay. Actually,
because we want to notify extremely fast.
Right, wonderful, sir. We'll try and match your speed. So, Rajesh, over to you for any announcements that you would like to make.
Well, thank you very much. I think, Mr. Goyal, thank you very much once again. It's a great pleasure to have you to interact with the industry immediately after the announcement of the scheme. And we now, of course, conclude the session. We have high tea outside. May I request all the participants to have a cup of tea or coffee before they leave the meeting. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Ayub Awad. Thank you.